hope you all are doing well. For today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you some more MTs because you guys seem to love MTs. I love MTs. I feel like I get a sense of achievement when I empty something out. I don't know why. I don't think using a product is an achievement, but I just really feel a big, big, big amount of satisfaction when I finish up something. So yes, today I'm going to be sharing with you guys some of my MTs. I have makeup, skincare, hair care, everything in there. So without any further ado, let's get into the video, but I will also throw up some timestamps right here so you guys know when we're gonna start with skincare, hair care, makeup, everything, and if there's a particular part you want to jump to, you can right now. But if you want to just go ahead and watch the video like normal human beings would, then keep on watching. Let's start off with the skincare stash, and the first product I have is the NYX Tripped Off Cleansing Oil. Now, I didn't really like this cleansing oil that much. I feel like it has a very weird smell. I don't know why, but cleansing oil smell weird. This one has a very weird smell, and plus it stung my eyes really bad every single time I washed my makeup off with this. So that's something I want to stay away from because my eyes are sensitive and I don't like anything that stings my eye. This one stung it really bad. So I finished it up while making sure that I didn't go around my eyes with this so much and only my face, and that's why I don't think I'm gonna be repurchasing this one. Next, I have the Bioderma CBM Gel Mousson, or the face wash, the gel face wash that they have. I really like this one, although it's supposed to be for oily skin, but because it's a gel based consistency, it's not too stripping for the skin. Perfect for summertime because it can feel a little heavy on the skin when you use a cream based face wash, but this one just felt so refreshing, so nice. Definitely would recommend this one if you're someone who has acne prone skin or oily skin that just doesn't comply with a lot of different face washes. This one cleanses your skin without stripping it down. Next up, I have the Botanical Lab Pumpkin and Papaya Enzyme Daily Exfoliator. It's a super, super gentle daily exfoliating toner, and it just helps in retexturizing your skin. It has a blend of AHAs and BHAs in there, so it helps from the topical layer as well as from underneath in there. So it's great for people who suffer from things like clogged pores and uneven skin texture. This would help in tackling all of that, but in a gentle manner. Just make sure you top it off with a sunscreen, and definitely if Botanical Lab is available in India anytime soon, I would be repurchasing this. Then I have my love, my forever favorite. I finished bottles and bottles of this. I'm talking about the Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair. I have loved this since a while now, and every single time I use something new, I always tend to go back to this because the way this works on my skin is magical. I don't know, there's something in this formulation that just makes my skin so beautiful. Every single time my skin is going through something, I know this is what I need to add into my skincare for it to go back to normal. It's just a beautiful product. I love it. I already have so many backups of this, like so many. I'm not even kidding you. I probably have like 5 or 6 bottles of this already at my place because I love it so freaking much. Another serum-like product that I finished is the Belief Numero 10 Essence. Now, I know it says it's an essence, but this is supposed to go on your skin even before a toner does because this has a lot of humectant in there. So it helps in your skin holding all of that water and making sure that your skin has nice amount of hydration and bounce and plump in going there. And this one is a beautiful. Beautiful. I love to apply this, especially after I'm done with the chemical exfoliating routine. This one just goes next on to my skin because I don't tone after I chemically exfoliate my skin. So once I'm done with chemical exfoliation, like a strong chemical exfoliation, this is the one that I directly go to, slap this on, lather this on my skin, and it just helps my skin in recovering and repairing so quickly and just healing up so quickly. Love this stuff. I already have another backup of this one because it's beautiful. Then we finished an eye cream. This is the It Skin Collagen Nutrition Eye Cream. I'll be honest, I didn't really see any difference with this. It's a huge dupe, so you know you should have been ideally able to see a difference. I didn't really see a difference with this one. I just felt it adds a nice moisture to my skin, but that's something any cream would have done, not even eye cream, any cream would have done. So for me, this is a hard pass. I don't think I will be repurchasing this. We have a couple of moisturizers to talk about, so let's get through them really quickly. The first one I have is the Therapy Oil Blending Cream. Oh my god, so beautiful this one is. It's like a very thick, luxuriant moisturizing cream. Perfect for people who have dry skin because it's just so rich, so luxuriant. What I specifically liked this was also applying it as a night mask because the morning, the next morning, your skin looks so beautiful. It has a little bit of oil component in there that just enriches your skin so beautifully. It's just a beautiful cream. Definitely repurchasing this once I'm done with a little bit more of my moisturizers. I have a very healthy stash of moisturizers, but this one, if you're looking for something that would help with your dry skin, beautiful. Next moisturizer that we have is Believe the True Cream Moisturizing Balm. The reason this finished up so quickly is because half of it was already finished when I was in sessions. This is a beautiful gel-based cream, but very, very moisturizing. As they say, it's the moisture balm. A lot of Believe's products are formulated with a lot of humectant in there because they just tend to absorb all of the moisture from the environment and just put it in your skin. And that's why I took this with me to Seychelles, because it's a very humid place, right? So this just really helped in my skin not drying out in the sun and just helping my skin a lot over there. So if you live in a hot and humid area, you would love this cream. I am currently in a very dry situation, okay? Delhi has dry heat, not humid heat, it has dry heat. So I prefer using this at nighttime and then just loading it off with a lot of oil or maybe a facial spray, just to make sure that the moisture is taken from outside and not from my own body. Then we finished the Pond's Light Moisturizer. Great moisturizer for daily use, especially in summertime, because it's not greasy, it's not oily. I also love the Super Light Gel, but even this is a very good purchase for people of oily skin, and the Super Light might be a little too light for you. So this one is just so beautiful, non-greasy, affordable. What else could you ask for? Another product that I have finished a ton of previously is Clinique Moisture Surge. Another one of those products that I just know I can rely upon, but somehow this time around, it didn't feel that moisturizing on the skin. Like, I had to load up a lot of it. Might be that my skin is going a little dry. I don't know what it was, but I had to load up a lot of it. I do have a lot of backups of it, so I am sorted for that. I'll see how my skin is reacting and changing in this weather and all of the stress about quarantine and everything. But overall, it's a beautiful moisturizer, very light gel weight, and just a very nice moisturizer. It gets absorbed into your skin so quickly, makes it radiant and glowy. Love this stuff, so good. Just that I need to see if my skin's changing and it's a little too light for my skin or not. Next up, I finished the Laneige Special Care Lip Sleeping Mask in the Berry variant. Oof, I love this lip balm. It's such a beautiful lip balm. Rich, luxuriant, moisturizing, protecting, everything nice that you want in a lip balm is there in this lip balm. I already have a backup of this one because I'm addicted to lip balms. But yes, it's a very, very nice lip balm. It's definitely on the pricier side of things, but totally worth it. The last skincare item on this list before we move on to other categories is this Face Shop Cacao Hand Cream. How cute is that? It's a very lightweight hand cream, which I think is perfect for times like what we are in right now, because I don't want to apply that something super moisturizing, as I am going to be washing my hands every 1 hour or so. Like, I've washed my hands very frequently. Something that's light and not supremely moisturizing that I would be so sad in washing off is great for times like right now. So this is a very lightweight, just nice, very easy to use hand cream. On my regular basis, when I'm not washing my hands like a maniac, maybe I wouldn't have thought about using this so much because it's a little too light for me, but right now it's just perfect. Let's move on to hair care. I finished the Sunita Somani Natural Beauty Secret Pure Homemade Hair Oil. Now this one smells strong, okay? I have to warn you guys, the smell of this one, it's a little too much. Maybe because I don't eat onions and this one does have onions in there, so maybe because of that. But it smells strong. It definitely does moisturize your hair. I didn't really see hair growth that much. I don't really feel like something can make your hair grow, like if it's on steroids, except if you're actually taking some supplements. But yeah, as a nice moisturizing hair oil, it does a really good job, and that's that from my side for this one. Next, I finished the Mamaearth Tea Tree Shampoo. I got this because I really like the tea tree mask, but I was underwhelmed with the shampoo. It's too thick for the packaging. It's difficult to take out from the packaging. It doesn't really wash your hair very nicely. Like, it doesn't perform that well. Especially if you have oil in your hair, you have to wash your hair a minimum of 4 times, which really strips off your scalp. And this one is supposed to prevent dandruff, and I do have a very flaky scalp because my skin is dry overall. This didn't really help with my flakes at all. So, you know, I already have another one of this. I don't know what I'm gonna do with that because I didn't really like this one. Neither did my mom. Even she didn't like it. So we both are just like, we just need to finish this off so that we can move on to better shampoos. So yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be repurchasing this. I'm just gonna use whatever I have in my cupboard already. But overall, not so impressed with this one. I also finished the Garnier Ultra Blends Revitalizing Conditioner. I really like it. It's affordable, it's paraben free, it has natural extracts for healthy hair and whatnot. It moisturizes the hair, it gets the job done of a conditioner, and that's why I like it. I would definitely repurchase it once I'm done with the 50 million conditioners that I already have lying at my place. And then I finished something that defies my current rule of not buying something till I finish something in my cupboard, and that is Coco Soul's conditioner and cleanser. Oh my god, this duo, it's magical, you guys. So beautiful. It made my hair look so shiny, so healthy, so bouncy. So just everything nice that you want from a conditioner and a cleanser. It's just so good. These are SLS and paraben free, which is like, what? Generally, a lot of SLS free shampoos don't really work on my scalp that well because I do tend to oil them so much. But this one, oh my god, guys, you need to get this one. Especially if you are on a journey of not using SLS and paraben on your hair, you're gonna love this one so much. This is also free of silicones, which again blows my mind because conditioners generally work on the law of silicones because they have silicones and that's why they condition your hair. This one just blew my mind away. I'm definitely going to be repurchasing this. Doesn't matter how many shampoos and conditioners I already have. This is going to get into my cart real soon. Alrighty, that's that with hair care. Let's move on to makeup. The first product I finished is the Smashbox Photo Finish Radiance Primer. Love this one so much. It makes your skin look so healthy, so glowy, so beamy. Already have a backup of this, but would definitely recommend this. If you have a little extra to spend on your primer, this one, so beautiful. It also moisturizes your skin, makes your skin look so even, so glowy, and just chumeshwari. Another primer I finished is the Maybelline Master Prime Primer. Now this is the complete opposite of the Smashbox one. This is supposed to mattify your skin, fill into those pores, make you look flawless and blurred out. And that's why I love this one as well, because it just makes my skin look so flawless. Although I add in a lot of glow with my highlighters and everything, so it doesn't really give my skin a glowing from within sort of an appeal, but it just makes my skin look so perfected, like I have no flaws at all. Really like this one. It's an affordable one. And if you have issues of pores and everything and you want something to just make sure that it looks a little more filled in, this is the one to go for. I finished my first contouring bronzing product. I am so proud of myself. It's not even funny. I have finished the Hoola Quickie Contour Stick and I've literally finished it through and through. It's such a beautiful product. It blends into your skin like butter, like a dream, whatnot. It's like Tantor from Huda Beauty, but in a stick form that came before Tantor as well. It's just so good, you guys. It looks phenomenal on the skin. I love how this looks. I already have a backup of this one because it works on my skin so well. You can use it on bare skin, with makeup, with anything. It doesn't move your foundation. Love, love, love this one so much. Another benefit empty that I have with me is the Goof Proof Brow Pencil. You've seen me using this, you've seen me loving this, but I do have to say I have fallen in love with precisely my brow a little bit more than I am with this one. Although this is a very good pencil, it's just beautiful, makes your brows look really nice, the spoolie is amazing. But if you are going to be buying a new brow pencil and you want to get it from Benefit, I would suggest precisely my brow over the Goof Proof for sure. Then I have the Nykaa Liquid Liner, and this is not in my empties because I've used it so much, but it's here because it dried up. And I think it's completely my fault because I don't tend to use the liquid liners so frequently, and then they obviously will dry up after a while. But I think this dried up before its expiry. This is supposed to expire on 8th month of the 20th year. That means 8/2020, and it's already expired and dried and I cannot use it, so that's a bummer. But nonetheless, it's a nice liquid liner. Just make sure that you have to use this within like a year or a half, I would say. I have finished my beloved Huda Beauty Glue. I think this is my third tube. I have shown this in a couple of my empties, but this is my favorite lash glue of all times. It just makes sure that my lashes stay in place all day long, no matter how long the day is. And it's a nice lash glue is all I would say. Yes, it can be a little intimidating because it's black in color, but oh my god, it is amazing. I'm waiting when I can buy it. I don't know if it's available on Nykaa or not. If it is, I will buy it only once it's a little bit more safer. I am making do with the other lash glues that I'm not the biggest fan off with right now because I feel like my lashes are not more important than my and anyone else's life, and I don't want to risk that. But overall, I will definitely be repurchasing this once I can. Then I finished the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus. This is the rose variant, but I really like the Fix Plus range as whole. This one, oh my god, it made my makeup look so well meshed in together and just so beautiful. My makeup also stayed for longer after using this, and whenever I felt like my makeup is going a little cracky, a little because I do shoot like throughout the day, and obviously even if I am indoors, my makeup will tend to break away and just melt down on my skin. I just used to spray my face with this, like take a quick little shot in this one, and my makeup used to look so much more fresher. So I really, really like this, and plus they also have mini sizes in this, so it's great for carrying around with you, especially when you know you're going to be in places for a longer time and you need a touch up, but you don't want to powder your face so much because that tends to make your face look cakey, just carry this with you, spray this on, and your skin would look so good. Next, I finished my second bottle of e.l.f. makeup mist and set. Love this so much. It's a very nice lightweight spray. It's just so good, so fine, so nice, and again it just adds such a healthy glow to your skin. I've previously finished a bottle of this, and this was my second and my last bottle. I don't have a backup of this because I couldn't order it well in advance, but once I can, I would definitely repurchase this. I really like this. It's affordable, beautiful. Love it. And the last setting spray I finished is the NYX Dewy Finish Spray. Again, something that I really like because it's just so good. It adds such a glow to your skin. It's a dewy finish spray, so it's perfect for people who have dry skin or for people who want their skin to look glowy even after they've powdered their skin 10 times. This is the one to go for because it just makes your skin look very natural, very my skin but better sort of, even if you're wearing like a full coverage foundation. And that's why I love this one. I already have another backup of this, so I'm sorted for a while. And the last product I finished, a pretty random one at it, is the Pure Sense Macadamia Tranquil Sleep Spray. I've been trying sleep sprays because if you don't know this about me, I have issues with my sleep. I can't fall asleep. My sleep isn't very peaceful. So I've been trying my hands at aromatherapy. So sleep sprays are a part of that. And I have to say it has helped. You have to keep in mind that this is not magic. This is not a sleeping pill. And it would only work if you wanted to work. All right. You have to do a little bit of work from your end as well when you are trying to relax and everything. This would do a little bit of the work by trying to, you know, make you feel relaxed. So you have to give it a little bit of time. There would be still days when this won't work, when your mind is not as calm as it's supposed to be, but overall I really did like this one. I'm trying another one right now, but I would definitely be repurchasing this because it's a beautiful fragrance. I really like it and how calming it is. And with that, we finished another session of MTs. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then don't forget to comment and subscribe. It would mean the absolute world to me. Also, let me know what did you empty out in this month, and we can just, you know, start a conversation about our MTs and what we are planning to empty or what we've already emptied. I'm not making much sense, I'm just rambling on. But yes, I will see you guys next time. Till then, take care, stay home, stay safe. I love you all so much. Bye. That dance was weird, but I still hope you love me.